Nikola Jokic is definitely one of the hottest things in the league right now, man. The dude can literally do everything. Bring the ball up, run the offense, pick and pop, kill you from outside, post up, little post fades, you know, go to the rim, roll with a little layup. He ain't dunking on nobody. He's definitely not known for defense, but he's so versatile that he's got the Denver Nuggets in the Western Conference Finals, man. I'm going to show you how to make this bill, and hopefully you can enjoy it. But we're going to put a little J-Eazy sauce on it right after this. Lito!
If you make it to C25, that's OG status. I was told you could be anything, just don't be average. Down bad, flat pockets, that shit made me a savage. Start hustling nonstop, don't plan on breaking that habit.
Now, the first thing that you're going to have to do if you want to make an authentic Joker is get the face right. When you come into the face builder, it's going to be the face that's 3 over and 4 down. So you go row, you go column 1, 2, 3, row 4. Just go down 4. After that, it's all academic. I got this build from SJS Prod, man. I'm going to leave the link to that down in the description. But like I said, this one came out to be a pretty authentic build. And the only difference is that Joker lost a little bit of weight this year. And with that being the case, you know, he's going to look a tad bit different. But I think this is going to give us the most authentic look, feel, and just downright Joker-ish, Joker-isms. I don't even know what you want to call it, man. But the way that he's looking now, he's slim, he's trim. He's not the same Joker that he was at the beginning of the year, you know, with pre-bubble basketball and all that. But I feel like this is still a really close representation to what he is. So go in, go check out his video. That link is in the description. Or you can just pause this video and match the numbers up and all of that good stuff. Hopefully, you come out with something just as authentic looking as what I was able to produce right here. Now that we got the face out of the way, it's time to go with everything else. So you're going to come in, make him number 15, right-handed center. Just like the real Joker, man. We're going to take the shooting primary pie chart because it's the only one that gives us enough three ball as a center to be viable from three. Anything else you're going to get below 80, and we already know how that works out. We took the third pie chart, which is strength and speed, and you'll see why. And we're just going to apply these attributes just like this. We're gonna max out pretty much everything here. Not gonna max out the ball handling though, just because we only want 10 badges at playmaking. Now you could max out that, you could max that out and you could have more than 10 playmaking badges, but I just felt like that's really the only thing that I needed was 10 playmaking badges. You can go up to 12, I do believe, if you max out the dribbling, but at what cost? To do that, you'd have to probably take down your steal or take down your layup. And you want to have some driving layup. You don't need a lot as Joker because you're going to be using the shot stick when you go to the rim and stuff like that. But what will happen when you do all of this? You're going to end up with one finishing badge, 30 shooting badges, which is more than enough. You don't even need 30 shooting badges. So you can definitely adjust some things. 10 playmaking badges, and you're going to have 9 defensive badges. Like we said, Joker not known for his defense, so 9 defensive badges is good. You're going to make him 7 feet tall like real life, 275, burly body type. Leave the wingspan alone because you just don't benefit really anything from doing that. And we're going to take the post score takeover because, hey, he is the master of the post. And what this is going to give you is a 3-level score. Now, if you make this build at 6'9", which I do recommend making it at 6'9", it's going to give you a stretch 5. And that's what I have it as. But if you want to be true to Joker, you're going to have to make it at 7'. And now for the badges, man. Like, you don't have many finishing badges, so I just put it on Slithery Finisher. I always feel like that's a good default. Anytime you put on Slithery, it'll make the guy jump a little bit early. And so you can definitely use that when you're going in for layups and stuff like that. Shooting badges, you can really do anything you want. I did catch and shoot, clutch shooter, corner specialist, dead eye, slippery off ball, hot zone hunter, range extender, pick and pop. But you could definitely go with deep fades and stuff like that. Ice in your veins, green machine. Any of those, hot start. You don't even need hot start with this build though, especially if you're shooting with the stick and all that. But you can space those out any way that you really want to. I would definitely put on deep fades though, because they're gonna help you with your fadeaway shot. For the playmaking badges, we went with bailout and needle threader. So you're gonna need those to be able to pass out of double teams. Cause I mean, you're the Joker. Come on, man. Dream shake so you can shake fools down low. quick first step so when you're on the perimeter, you can go by an unpluckable so they can't steal the ball from you as a center as soon as you get it. And defense, you know, you don't have a whole lot of defense. He's got that big, thick body, so, you know, you're going to put it on box intimidator. Pogo stick so you can get up and down over and over. And rim protector just so you can unlock some block animations. Now, you can put it on rebound chaser, but I just feel like he's going to be so slow. You're not really going to be able to chase for a lot of rebounds, and we automatically know that the game automatically magnetizes the ball to you anyway, or whoever's going to go to. So as long as you can box people out and keep them from getting to the ball, you should be able to have a very good chance at it, and your teammates should have a good chance at it too. But now that we got the badges out of the way, let's get right into the gameplay. We're going to be picking the Larry Bird jump shot because that's probably the closest one to him as a raw jumper, and we're going to go from there. Let's get it! Time to get it started, man. Let me tell y'all something, man. I've been having so much fun with this building. Even though I don't have it at 7 feet tall, I promise you, it's the most fun that you can have in the park, especially with some of the badges that you get to have on the perimeter and stuff like that, man. I mean, it is just a very fun experience. Being able to stretch the floor, make some plays for your team, all that type of stuff, man, it's just great. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. A little dream shake. Ah! Come here! Get over here! They can't stop me down there. With the dead eye too? It don't matter what they do, what they throw at me. Now that we're doing that, we're going to try to space the floor out a little bit. Get over here. Ah! Trey's up! Splash down. Y'all already know Jokic can stroke it, man. I might change his name to Stroke It. Okay, passing out the double team. Passing out of the double team. Trey's up. Splash down. That's what Jokic does, baby. Let's get it. Jokic one more time. Oh, look at the needle. Right. Look at the needle thread of pass, baby. Look at the needle thread of pass. That's what Jokic does, man. Draw the double team and then find the quite pass out of that, man. Let's go. Come here. Come here and get the dream shake, baby! That's too much space. That's too much space! That's too much space, baby! I told you! Three-level scorer, baby. If you make him at 6'9", though, you're going to be a stretch 5, so just be aware of that. And you'll have better shooting and everything. Like, I think that 6'9 is probably the sweet spot for this build just because you're faster, you'll be able to shoot more efficiently and score better and stuff like that. But if you want to make him a 7 foot, 7 footer, do your thing. Woo, find the open man. That's what Jokic does. Trays up, splash down. That's what Jokic does. Initiate the offense, find the open man. Then we can get some pick and pop action going. I said, let's see if we can get some pick and pop action going. Here we go. There's the pick. Here's the pop. The pick and pop. Let's get some pick and pop action going, baby. Master of the pick and pop. Y'all already know what it is, man. Big boards. Oh, this big joker can't even get off the ground. Like I said, I would not recommend making him 7 feet. But if you do, you know. Little dream shake. Woo, look at that shot close down low. He's too deep, baby. He's too deep. Let's see what they got for me. Double team coming. We saw it. Reset. Reset the double team. Dream shake. Huh. Spin baseline. Spin away from the double team. I don't know why Paul Millsap thought he should bring his guy down there and try to guard me. But, hey, it is what it is. Now, I think that I would definitely benefit from the deep fades badge because I just don't know, how far they'll let me fade, but I'm definitely recommending that. You can take one of those badges off, put deep fades on. It just really depends. Then we can go back into the post right here. Oh! Look at the Joker! Get that shot out! Picking pops. Quick corner. Quick pull! Quick mid-range, yes! Let's get out on the break. Let's get out. Oh! I got him! Filet! Yeah. Slow rolling, yeah. That's what that was right there. I'm not even gonna lie to you. Oh, down here. I got a baby. Woo, look at me get everybody. He got everybody with that, man. Like I said though, man, I don't recommend anybody make this at 7 foot. You're just gonna be too slow, especially as a shooter. Let's see who opened. Let's see. Oh, there he is. Plumlee. Right. I'm telling you, man. I'm telling you, Bailout and Needle Threader. They try to double me. I'm getting buckets. Somebody's getting buckets. It don't have to be me. I got Giannis. Double team coming. Hit Michael Porter Jr. Trey's up. Splash down. What you about to do, Giannis? Oh, made him step back. Trey's up. Splash down. See if we can get another bucket just for giggles. Come here. Get over here. That mid-range tough, man. I am not going to lie. And that's going to do it for us, ladies and gentlemen, man. We had 31 points that game. What, 33 points? Like I said, I would definitely make this guy 6'9 or so just because you're so much more versatile at 6'9. You get more dribbling, more speed, vertical, everything. Making it at 7 foot, you're going to be like Jokic for real. Like, you're definitely just going to be out there lumbering around and all of that stuff, man. It is just not going to be very conducive for anything. You could probably take the straight speed pie chart and not make him any stronger or anything like that, but then you might get pushed around. That's why I say make him like 6'9", 6'10", at the most. You make it 6'9", 6'10", at the most, you're going to have over 60 speed. You'll be up to 70 when you get your plus 8s, plus 9s, or what have you, and you're really going to be tough, man. But anyway, hope you guys enjoyed the video. Leave a like on the video, subscribe for more daily 2K content. Let's get this joint over 1,000 likes in the first 24 hours, man, so we can keep dropping the bangers on y'all. And go back and watch the video that I dropped last night, man. I did a lot of work on that joint editing, man. And I'ma holler at y'all next time. Till next time, it's your boy Jay Easy, aka Fresh from the Barbershop, BK the People's Champ. God, peace. Commence. It don't make cash and it don't make sense, cause we can't pay rent with no one's opinion. So in that sense, I never value your 2 cents. Hey, darn, please leave that bullshit you speak at the barn, cause I ain't fine. I'm only 5'8", that's fine, nigga. I could give a heart transplant to a giant. I ain't lying. Godspeed. We good.